Aaron, they're in the process now of boarding up this apartment building as investigators have just left the scene. Now, while those investigators say they don't know exactly how this fire started, they believe they have pinpointed the location, a second floor bedroom.
Seems like a nightmare.
Unfortunately for Donna Conway and her husband, Ron, the nightmare is all too real. Conway says they awoke around 1 o'clock Friday morning to smoke detectors going off and neighbors pounding on their door telling them the place was on fire.
We had to put on what clothes we could in a hurry because they wanted us out of the building, and I had to leave my cat in here, but he's fine.
According to fire officials, a total of 15 people lived at 100 Pearl Street, 14 of whom were home when the fire started. All were outside when firefighters arrived. Still, firefighters checked the four apartments and the basement to confirm that everyone was safe. One neighbor says that's what he was praying for as he looked at the inferno outside his window.
When I woke up, the flames were way out of the sidewalk. I mean, they were just coming out just as the fire department got here.
The fire would eventually go to three alarms and take about 2 hours to get under control. Deputy Chief Mark Howard says they were concerned about the fire spreading to neighboring homes. Indeed, the heat from the fire melted the siding on the house next door. Despite that, firefighters managed to limit most of the damage to the one apartment on the second floor where they believe the fire started.
There was extension into the apartment below. The two remaining apartments, one on the first floor and one on the second, suffered obviously some smoke damage, but have very little water damage or fire damage.
But Conway says the smell of smoke in her apartment was unbearable, and she's not sure if the place they've lived for 28 years will still be their home.
I just don't see how we're going to get back in here at all anytime soon, if at all.
Some of those displaced are staying with family and friends, while the American Red Cross is assisting the rest. Reporting live in Keene, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9. Right.